Praise God. Welcome sa ating household. Ang ating topic for household for this week is about growing in sanctifying grace. So I will just share yung few slides, no, para try to reflect on those messages, those reminders about this sanctifying grace. And as you can see, you know, yung title is to grow, growing in sanctifying grace, meaning we need to increase, we need to grow, not just parang yung stagnant, no? Yung parang wala lang. Baga happy-go-lucky, I mean, yung walang goal, walang ini-aim. So it's not a good characteristic of a Christian. We must grow in grace. We must grow in sanctifying grace. There are three ways in increasing sanctifying grace. Number one is about the fruitful reception of sacraments. So, we know na yung sacraments is instituted by Christ for us to receive grace. Grace is a supernatural favor from our God. And the primary means established by Christ to distribute sanctifying grace, it is from the sacraments. I always recall, no, from St. Montfort, sabi niya, alam na natin yung mga dapat natin gawin, pero bakit we failed to do those things for us to save our soul? For example, alam natin na kailangan natin mag-frequent the sacrament, mag-simba, magdasal, magbasa ng Bible and scriptures. We have that knowledge, but we failed to do those things, and one of the reasons because of lack of grace. Walang grasya. That's why hindi natin nagagawa. We failed to do, we failed to act. And again, no, to increase the sanctifying grace, we need to frequent the reception of sacraments. Alam mo yung mga sacraments? We have yung Eucharist, yung confession. So, yan yung ano, no, yung isa sa paraan para palaguin itong sanctifying grace. Number two, through prayer sa pamamagitan ng pagdadasal. And again, no, another saint, si Saint Alfonso Liguori. Yung prayer daw, if you will not pray, you will go to hell. Because if you're not praying, you don't know, or hindi mo alam, or wala kang direction sa buhay. Ibig sabihin, you will not be guided. So those who pray will be guided, and more or less, magkaroon siya ng grasya to know what's the God's will, grasya to stay on traveling on the narrow path. So that's why napakalaga po ng pagdadasal. We lift our heart, mind, and soul to God. One goal is in praying is to unite ourselves to our Lord, to be in union with Him. That's why napakalaga po nung meron tayong prayer life, a life in prayer. So directly asking God for an increase in grace. That's why one of the petition, kung mapapansin niyo, no? Every time I pray, I always ask for the increase of grace. Ang grasya ng Panginoon ay available, but no one asks for that. Ibig sabihin, we failed to ask for that graces. So that's why we really need to pray and ask to increase the sanctifying grace in our life, in our soul. Next, meritorious works. Supernatural reward for acts animated by charity, resulting in an increase of sanctifying grace. Every time we do good things, we receive merits if we are in the sanctifying grace. Ibig sabihin, we have the treasures, we have that reward because of that charity. So with that, it increases sanctifying grace in our soul. Bakit merong merit, no? I mean, because in heaven, there is a degree of glory. So the more merit, the more glory we have, the more we will be on that level of glory in heaven. So let's like continue to do good things, good acts, according to the will of the Lord. Loss and restoration of sanctifying grace. Kailan nawawala yung sanctifying grace? Every time we do the mortal sin, results in the loss of sanctifying grace, virtues, and gifts. That's why, alam nyo, I always emphasize, ako, I hirap din, but ganun talaga, and we just need to be more prayerful and be cautious enough every time we do mortal sin. And the only way to bring back into the sanctifying grace is by confession. Napakahalaga po, kapatid. That's why, alam nyo, sa catechism, if you really read the catechism of the Catholic Church, napakalalim at napakaganda. It will guide you, it will guide us on this journey. So, again, no, kailan mo masasabi na you did a mortal sin? Tatlo. Ibig sabihin, dapat itong tatlong to masatisfy. Kung meron dito na wala, it's not a mortal sin. Number one, grabe. Grabe ba yung ginawa na kasalanan? Number two, alam mo ba na yun ay kasalanan, knowledge? At number three, you had the consent, meaning you will eat. If these three are takes place, ibig sabihin, we did a mortal sin. Pero pag meron dito mawala na isa, hindi yun mortal sin. Every time we did a mortal sin, we are separated from our God. And it means na we're not in friendship with the Lord. Ibig sabihin, wala tayo sa Kanya, wala tayo sa radar Niya. Ibig sabihin, we are not with Him. Now, kaya napakahirap, no? Every time we are in this state of mortal sin, that's why lagi kong remind, let's go back. Go back and receive the sacrament of confession so that friendship with the Lord will be restored and we will receive again the sanctifying grace. Kailan pa? Kailan naman siya na-restore? Okay, ito yung kanina yung binabanggit ko, the sacrament of penance. Normal means of restoring sanctifying grace proportional to the disposition of the penitent. Napakahalaga po ng sacrament of penance at napakahalaga po ng pagkakaroon ng pari. Kasi kung walang pari, we will never receive that sacrament of confession, the sacrament of penance. And maraming mga bumalik sa Catholic faith, lalo na yung mga Protestant, because with on that Protestant than TSM, they don't have the sacrament of confession. How they will restore the sanctifying grace? That's why nung mga nag-aral about the Catholic faith, they go back to Catholic faith, silang mga Protestante. Weird lang, no? Yung mga Catholic na hindi nag-aral ng Catholic faith, sila yung mga naging Protestante. That's why napakahalaga po, kapatid, anytime na nag-aaral tayo ng Catechism, we will learn a lot and we will be guided. Number three, restoration of treasury of merits. Kursa po, the treasury of sanctifying grace. Mga kapatid, if we are in a state of mortal sin, everything na gawin natin, we will never have that merit. Ibig sabihin, walang say-say, because it will not be add up as a treasure in heaven. Walang points. Zero. If we do good things in the state of mortal sin. Pero, if we have that sanctifying grace in our soul and we do good things, we have that merit. We restore the treasury of merits. And again, no, iting sinasabi na let's make a treasure in heaven. Let's do and have those merits here by living in here in earth. Acquire those merits. Actually, when we pray the rosary, kasama yan. There is a merit with that because we reflect and pray the rosary. We reflect on the life of Jesus Christ. Kaya ganun, no? Kaya napakahalaga ng praying the rosary daily. And as for the grace, na sana hindi natin ma-miss or lagi tayong makarecover in praying the rosary, maging lifestyle natin siya. Importance of sanctifying grace. Necessary for eternal life. Required for entry into heaven along with at least one meritorious work that those who have attained the use of reason. Again, no? Napaka-importante po talaga ng sanctifying grace, especially in our salvation. Because if we die in the state of mortal sin, we will go to hell directly. Because si God, tsaka yung mortal sin, it can never be united or hindi pwede pagsamahin. That's why if we are in the state of mortal sin, our soul will never be the temple of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit will not dwell in us every time in the state of mortal sin. Never. That's why napakahalaga po talaga, no, na maibalik yung sanctifying grace by confession. Conformity to Christ reflects Christ's salvific acts, emphasizing the importance of merit. Again, no, the sanctifying grace, it conforms us to Christ. Ibig sabihin, we align our will with the Lord. We try to be united with our Lord Jesus Christ. And we have that merits, no, every time we do good things because of Jesus Christ. We conform to Christ. We be like Christ. We act like Christ because of the sanctifying grace. And last, determines heavenly happiness, degree of sanctifying grace implements degree of happiness and glory in heaven. Binabanggit ko kanina, no? There is a degree of glory in heaven. If we will be there, the more the sanctifying grace, the more merit we have those level, no? The degree of glory. And let's continue as for the grace na, let's aim higher. Not just isipin natin, okay, naka sa purgatory. No, we are created for heaven. That's why, ask for the grace. Let's continue to pray and ask for the grace that in the end of our life here, that we will be in heaven. If not, if we'll be in purgatory, we pray that we will be also have that minimal stay in purgatory, that we will spend our life in heaven. Mga kapatid, kailangan natin aralin the four last things so that we'll have those knowledge about those important things that will happen in our life. Time's up. Thank you for listening and for the guide question, for your sharing. And the question is, what is sanctifying grace on your own words? Anong pagkakaintindi mo sa sanctifying grace on your own words? Explain it on how you understand it. If not, on this topic, ano yung natutuwa, ano yung nakuha mo na nag-struck sa'yo? Amen. Thank you for listening. God bless. Praise God.